Hey y'all, it's Charles Shapiro, President of the World Affairs Council. We just had a terrific lunch discussion with Dr. Lissa Ayers, who is the Council on Foreign Relations Senior Fellow for India, Pakistan, and South Asia, and who just got her book published, which is Our Time Has Come, about India. And it's an extraordinary book. I encourage you all to buy it. And I'm going to ask her a question. Lissa, are the United States and India allies?
Thank you for asking this question, Ambassador Shapiro, because it's an important piece of what I write about in the book. India and the United States have overcome decades of mistrust and a relationship of estrangement to become strategic partners. But that doesn't mean that we're allies in the traditional sense of a treaty alliance, a defense treaty. India is a very independent power. It has its own ideas of what it wants to do on the world stage. And having a close relationship with the United States doesn't necessarily mean that New Delhi wants to sign up for everything the United States decides to do around the world.
Do our national interests coincide?
They do, to a very great extent. But we have some differences on some issues, like Russia, like Iran. Oftentimes we see eye to eye with India on important issues like counterterrorism, but that doesn't mean that India wants to sign up for our global coalition against ISIL. So we sometimes have differences on tactics, we sometimes have some differences on questions of specific countries, but we are convergent on the high level questions of the world.
Does India perceive China as a strategic rival or enemy?
India has both a competitive and a cooperative relationship with China, but it is concerned about China's increasing influence in the South Asia region, China's growing assertiveness across the Indian Ocean space, its Belt and Road investments in many of the smaller countries that are around India. So it does have a number of concerns on that front.
And is that one reason why they're willing to have a closer relationship with us? Is there concern about China?
I think that a convergence of views on China and its role in Asia has helped bring India and the United States closer together, definitely. And I think this began happening about 12 years ago, about 15 years ago. So prior to some of the introduction of the Belt and Road, for example, I think this has been a process, we could call it a gradual geopolitical change that's been in place for some years. But it's an important piece of what has helped bring Indian and U.S. interest in a much more convergent space.
Are U.S.-Indian relations better today than they have ever been before?
I'd say yes. Yeah, they are at a high point. You've seen successive U.S. governments and successive Indian governments continue working together to deepen U.S.-India ties. So that actually has been a bipartisan success story for both countries.
For both in the U.S. and in India.
Yeah, it's pretty remarkable. It's kind of unusual to have a case like this where there aren't deep partisan divides on either side.
That's great. Yeah. Listen, thank you so much. I appreciate it. And I want to tell everybody out here, be sure to buy the book so they can get the full answer and not the synopsis.
I couldn't ask for a better introduction than that. Thank you.
Great.
Happy to be in Atlanta.
Good. Thanks.
Thank you.